Hello friends, welcome to the channel Data Science Lovers. This is our fifth video of the course Data Analysis in Python. In this video, we will cover the topic of sets. What is a set in Python? Just like list and tuples, a set is also a collection of different data types like integers, floats, or strings. The each element or value of the set is called an item. We can also say that a set is a sequence of different items. A set is created within these type of curly braces. Now, how a set is different from a list or a tuple? A list is created within the square brackets, while a tuple is created within the round brackets, and a set is created within these type of curly braces. The second difference is the list items can be changed, while the tuple items cannot be changed, and in the set we can add or remove any element once this set is created. Now this is the format of a set. It is showing that there are two curly braces, and in the curly braces we can add the integer, float, or string values, or a combination of all these three data types. So to create a set, we have to write our set name like A and write the curly braces, and in the braces we have to enter the values. Like this. So this is a simple set that we have created. If I want to show you the type of this, then it will show this set as a type. We can also create a set with all the float values also, like this. This is also a set which contains all the float values. We can also create a set with all the string values also. This is a set which contains all the string values. Now to create a set which contains all these three data types, we can simply write like this. These are the integers values. These are two float values, and we can also write the string values like this. So this is how we can create a simple set. Now if we talk about the index in a set, then we can say that a set is unindexed. What does it mean? If this is a set that we have, and if I want to see what is present at my first index, then it will not show, it will show an error. Similarly, if I want to see what is present at my fourth index, then it will show an error. It means there is no index present in a set, means index are not there in the concept of the sets. Now if we talk about the properties of a set, then the first property is it arranges the items in the ascending order. What does it mean? If I create a set like 2, 1, 3, 6, 5, and if I print this set, then you can see that all the items that we have written in the sets are arranged in the ascending order, like 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. Similarly, it will arrange all the float as well as the string items in the ascending order. If I write 3, 2, 5, 1 and some float values like this, and also some string values like this, and if I print this set, then you can see that all the items of the sets are arranged in the ascending orders, like 1, 1, 2, 3, 3.2, 5, and then the all string values are also arranged in their alphabetical order. So this is the first property of a set. The second property is a set doesn't allow duplicate items or value in it. If I create a set like 1, 2, 3, 3, and 5, 6, 7, 7, And if I print this, then you can see all the duplicate items like 3 and 7 are removed in the resulted set. Similarly, it will remove any string value also and only show the unique values of the set. This is the second property of a set. The third property of the set is we can add or delete items in a set. If we have a set like this, and I want to add a new element in this set, then I will write the set name and the dot, and I will press the tab button on the keyboard. It will show some option to me like add. I will select this add option, and in the bracket I will write the value or element that I have to add in this set. If I write 67 and see the resulted set, then 67 has been added. Similarly, if I want to add 1.5 here, then you can see that 1.5 has been added between 1 and 2, which shows the set's items are arranged in the ascending order by default. When we add 67, the 67 adds to the last position. While we add the 1.5, it adds to this position between 1 and 2. If I want to remove any element from the set, then I will write my set name and dot and press the tab button and use the remove function from it. If I want to remove this 7.8, then I will pass this value here, and the value has been removed, as you can see here. If I want to remove 67, I can write the function name or I can select it from the tab button. You can see that the 67 has been removed. Now there is a different option like pop. What does it mean? If I use the pop function, then it will remove a value randomly from this set. If I use this, then it is showing that 1 has been removed from this set. If I again use the pop function, then it is showing that the 2 has been removed from the set. Here you see that 1 is removed, which was at our first position. But when we use pop second time, then the 2 was removed, which was our second position. It means that if we use pop function, then the values are removed randomly from the set. Again, if I use the pop function, then this time this removed the 4, and the resultant set will be our this. So friends, this is all about sets, and more advanced functions of the sets will be covered in our another playlist of the course, which is Advanced Data Analysis Python. So friends, don't miss any video of this course. Subscribe the channel to get the notification of all the videos.